Thank you. on the communion antiphon of today's Mass on the Ascender Wednesday in Lent. Listen to my plea. Pay heed to my cry of petition, my King, my God. To thee my prayer goes up, O Lord. From Psalm 5. We know nothing about the author of this psalm. It will be easier to appreciate the prayer if we imagine it coming from the lips of a priest or Levite on his way to the temple early in the morning for sacrifice and prayer. Without difficulty, this setting can be applied to Christian life, and we could then entitle the psalm, A Prayer on the Way to Mass. The composition has many points to qualify it as appropriate at the beginning of the day. Relative to content, it is divided into five stanzas, which are quite similar in external form. Hearken to my words, O Lord, attend to my singing. Heed my call for help, my King and my God. To you I pray, O Lord. At dawn you hear my voice. At dawn I bring my plea expectantly before you. For you, O God, delight not in wickedness. No evil now remains with you. The arrogant may not stand in your sight. You hate all evildoers. You destroy all who speak falsehood. The bloodthirsty and the deceitful the Lord abhors. But I, because of your abundant kindness, will enter your house. I will worship at your holy temple in fear of you, O Lord. Because of my enemies, guide me in your justice. Make straight your way before me. For in their mouth there is no sincerity. Their mouth teems with treacheries. Their throat is an open grave. They flatter with their tongue. Punish them, O God. Let them fall by their own devices. For their many sins, cast them out because they have rebelled against you. But let all who take refuge in you be glad and exult forever. Protect them, that you may be the joy of those who love your name. For you, O Lord, bless the just man. You surround him with the shield of your good will.
Thank you.
from the introit to this morning's Mass, from Psalm 24. Every age, Lord, gives proof of thy pity and thy mercy. Remember them now. Be it not said that our enemies triumphed over us. Deliver us, God of Israel, from all our difficulties. All my heart, Lord, goes out to thee. My God, I trust in thee. Do not belie my trust.
Thank you.
In mercy heed our prayers, we beg thee, Lord, and stretch forth thy right hand of thy majesty against all that is hostile to us. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, thy Son, who livest and reignest with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, God throughout all ages, world without end. Amen. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit. You have redeemed me, O Lord, O God of truth. We pray thee, Lord, to look with favour upon thy people's devotion, so that they may, whose bodies are mortified by abstinence, may through good works be refreshed in mind. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who livest and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, God, throughout all ages, world without end. Amen. Christ, Saviour, Son of the Father, give us peace. pray for all those who, in this holy season of Lent, are striving through fast and abstinence and self-discipline and prayer and study to grow more closely and nearly and dearly to Thee. We pray for their struggle and for their endeavour every day as we follow in the footsteps of Jesus, striving to become more like Him. Lord, we pray for those who are experiencing homelessness. For those who face the streets this evening, the cold and the disquiet. Fear and the hunger. We pray for those who are alone, for those in distress, for those suffering anxiety. Those struggling with addiction and vice, for those who struggle with themselves internally, for those who despair. Those who are fearful, for those struggling with the complexities of life. Those who hunger and thirst, for those who worry about providing for others, for dependence, for all those who struggle financially, for those who are burdened by debt. Those struggling to make ends meet. For those unable to clothe themselves. Or those whom they care for. For those who are sick. For those who can't afford medicine. For all those who suffer in mind, body and spirit. We pray for those who are suffering for the faith, for those enduring persecution, threats, and physical violence, for those who have been injured,
those who have been hurt, for those who have been scarred. For those who have been made strangers in their own land. For those who have lost their homes. For those who have watched their loved ones die. For all those who suffer for bearing thy name. Pray for the witness of the church in this place. For the guidance of the Holy Spirit. For the empowerment of the Holy Spirit. For the strength of the Holy Spirit. Christians here may see and recognize and seize those opportunities to proclaim the gospel, to demonstrate the love of God, to welcome the stranger, to feed the hungry. Succour those who thirst. Clothe the naked. Visit the sick and those in prison. That we may be the hands and feet, living icons of Christ. Instruments of God's will. Refresh us and imbue us with your grace, O Lord, that our hearts may share their stories and testify to your love and glory in our lives.